Hello, ELTR 1004-9W0. This is a brief explanation with photo demonstration for our Unit 4 lab on Ohm's Law and Power. Looking at the lab, the first thing I want you to see is you've got five different resistors that you're going to be using for this lab. And once we get them out of the bag, they can get a little hard to identify without measuring them. And so they're small, they're little quarter watts, they got blue bodies, the colors are hard to see. So I decided I'm figuring out a way to keep mine organized through the entire semester. Let me show you what I did to organize my resistors. I went ahead and I grabbed 10 empty prescription bottles. They just happened to be the perfect length for the new straight resistors, and you can throw the bent ones in there too that have been used. And I took a Sharpie and I just labeled the top of each little jar with the value of the resistor that's inside. I'm going to also do my labs in such a way that I can keep track of which one is where on the board so that it's easy just to pull it off the board and pop it back in the correct container here, so I don't have to spend so much time measuring and getting out a magnifying glass and trying to figure out what colors are on that little blue body of that tiny resistor. So anyway, that's what I'm doing. You don't have to use prescription bottles. Grab yourself some snack size Ziplocs or whatever. Any 10 containers will do. Just make sure you label them well and try to keep your resistors organized. Now, for the first part of the lab, you're going to be measuring resistor value and playing with color code. We have nice resistors. They're 1% precision resistors in our kit, but they have the 5-band color code, and that's not real common. Most of the time, you're going to be using not such high precision resistors, and they're going to have the 4-band color code on. So what we're doing for the lab today, we are pretending that these are 5% precision resistors, and they have the 4-band color code. So what I want you to do is figure out what the 4-band color code is for all these resistors and mark it under color code. 4-band, not looking at the colors on the 5-band, but figure out what the 4-band color code would be. Then using the pretend 5% precision, I want you to calculate the upper and lower resistance limits based on the 5%. Then we're going to be measuring the values. And to measure the values, I'm going to show you how I set mine up to keep it simple. First of all, I want you to notice there is no power supply connected to my breadboard. Thus, all these power buses, blue, negative and red positive, are not hot. They're dead. And what I did was I put my resistors on straddling the valley here. So one lead for the resistor on one side, one lead for the resistor on the other side of that separating valley. Then I set my meter to the continuity ohm setting, push the orange select button so I would be measuring ohms, and then I put the lead in the continuity row for this side of the resistor and the continuity row for that side of the resistor, and I'm getting a reading. Then what I did was I just jumped over to the next resistor with the leads, and you can go read the first one, read the second one, third, fourth, fifth, all the way down the line, and I arranged the resistors in order. 100, 330, 1K, 2K, and 5.1K. So now when I go to take them off the board and put them back in my containers, I know exactly what's what. Just pop it off the board and stick it back in. So this is how I set up for the first one. So go ahead and measure your resistor values and then record them right here as both ohms and k-ohms. Once you've done that, compare your reading to your calculated upper and lower resistance limits based on the 5% tolerance and circle yes or no, is it within tolerance. That's part one. Part two of the lab, we are going to measure current through the resistor pushed by the 5-volt source, and we're going to calculate the power being dissipated by the resistor. So here's the schematic of how it's set up. This is our power supply right here, our 5-volt source with the built-in power switch. Notice our digital multimeter set to milliamps has to be in the circuit. The current actually has to flow through the meter before it flows through the resistor. So we have to set our circuit up that way. Now here in the lab, I've given you an example using a random resistor size for how to go through this, and I've spelled out pretty precise instructions. But let's take a quick look at the table to get you oriented to it. First of all, our supply, as I said, is 5 volts. The resistance value measured, you already did that back up here in table 1. You measured the resistance values and you put them here. So just copy the resistance values from there and stick them down here in this column of table 2. Then, using that measured resistance value and our 5-volt supply, I want you to calculate what the current should be, the theoretical current. So I equals E divided by R, your measured R. Once you've done that, then we are going to measure the circuit current for each of these scenarios, 100 ohm, 5 volts, 330 ohm, 5 volts. We're going to compare our measured with our calculated. Now let me show you some photos of how I set up my circuit to measure current. First, I want you to see that I have hooked my power up to that USB port, but I have not yet turned on the power switch. What I did with my resistors is I put one end of the resistors in the negative power bus. The blue line is where the negative power bus is. There's a negative sign. And I took it over and straddled the valley on the other top side of the board. So that's how I first set up the resistors. Well, now that the resistors are set up like that, what I've done is I've taken my meter. I've set my meter for milliamps because I'm not exceeding 500 milliamps. I'm leaving the red lead here in the volt, ohm, milliamp, microamp, continuity, diode, etc., etc., jack here on the meter. And I've taken the red lead of the meter and I've set it permanently here in the positive power bus at the top side of the board. Then the negative lead I have put in the continuity row right here with the other end of the resistor. So you can see this end of the resistor is already in the negative bus. So the current's going to flow there, flow there, flow there, up through the meter, back out of the meter, through the red line, and over to the positive side of the supply. So that's how I set it up, and this is how it looks a little more out in the open here. Power supply there, meter set to milliamps, and I'm getting a reading. Now here's the nice thing about this. The red lead can stay where it is. All I have to do is move the black lead down to the next resistor, just like this. Move it down to the next resistor, and it looks like that pulled out. I can go back, give you the close-up again. You can see the lead is on the other side of the valley, and it's in the continuity row with the black lead from the meter. And that's what it looks like pulled out. And I can step down again for a third time. I can do all 5 resistors like that and get all my current readings. And my current readings will be recorded in this column. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to calculate power twice. Excuse me. I'm going to start by calculating power. Watts equals amps times volts. But I'm first going to use the calculated current to calculate power, put it here. Then I'm going to calculate power again using my measured current. So in this P equals amps times volts, I'm going to use these amps. In this, watts equals amps times volts, I'm going to use these amps. And I get that all recorded, and I can compare my theoretical calculated value for watts compared to based on a measurement for actual current. So that'll give you an idea there. The third part is supposed to be if we had a variable power supply. And unfortunately, we do not. We have a fixed 5-volt DC. So this part of the lab will be pretty much calculations only. This would be the schematic, how it would look if we set it up. And this would be, again, measuring current. But the variable power supply, we would get a readout on this of how many volts we were applying. So let's look at the table where you're going to be calculating. I'm only using three of the resistors for this. And what I'm doing is I'm selecting a desired current that I want to have. So I have to figure out, first of all, I'm going to measure my resistance. I can copy that measured resistance value from tables above, but then I'm going to calculate based on that measured resistance value and the desired current that I want, what would the supply voltage have to be through that resistor to give me that current. Now remember, using Ohm's law, we can't use milliamps. We have to change that to amps. So this would be 0.045 amps in my calculation. So my voltage would be 0.045 times my measured close to 330 ohms. And that's going to give me what the required voltage would be to push that many milliamps through that much resistance. Then I want to calculate my power again. This time, watts equals amps times volts. The amps is going to be the desired amps over here. Again, changed to base units. This would be 0.045 amps. And the voltage that I calculated right here. That'll give me my calculated power. Then I've got two pages of questions I want you to answer before we go forward. And make sure you get all your tables filled out, get your answers on these two pages, and send me this completed Word file to get credit. So hopefully this helps you do this week's lab, and I'll catch up with y'all later.